All right, let's get caught up on what is now Tropical Storm Eta. It was a depression earlier, but since seeing the center of the storm redevelop underneath these thunderstorms, and it's really starting to strengthen a little bit now. So maximum sustained winds are up to 40 miles per hour. We're seeing some of these stations that are over in the Cayman Islands. You can see that observation to 40. That's what caused them to pull the trigger and call this a tropical storm. Hurricane hunters are flying through this right now, too. In fact, their plane is flying through the center of it, and this should be interesting to see if maybe it's a little bit stronger than that 40 miles per hour. We'll have to wait and see. It definitely looks on satellite like it's getting itself together, and that's what we've expected, was this to strengthen a little bit approaching Cuba, so that's not too surprising. This is the latest cone that they just put out, by the way, coming off the coast of Cuba. This is going to be tomorrow morning, 50 mile per hour wind, so it's about 24 hours from now. By the time we get to early Monday morning, so this is mainly before the sun rises, we're looking at the storm pushing on shore. Now, they did adjust the track close to Miami. I know this line, the center of the cone, was closer to, let's say, Isla Mirada. Now they shifted it farther to the north, coming in somewhere around Key Largo or Homestead. But again, there's a cone there, so that's just if it were to follow down the center of the cone. Hurricanes don't move in, or tropical storms don't move in straight lines. They kind of wobble around a little bit, but it's not the center that matters with this one, because the impacts are going to be felt so far out compared to a usual tropical storm. So this one's going to be a little bit different. So far, we've had some heavy rain overnight, but we've had a nice break over the past 4 or 5 hours or so. This is just some spotty rain. That's why I have coverage at about 60% at any given time, just to cover those spotty showers. That's going to be up in Fort Lauderdale and Miami. If you're getting south of Homestead, you're going to get occasional burst of rain that'll last a little bit longer. This is where the steadier rains are. I know it's been raining a good chunk of this morning in Key West. You have a whole lot more to go today, and you can see by 6 o'clock that most of that rain is still down by the Keys. Overnight tonight, it turns more of those rain bands. This is where the flooding threat really gets going. This is by 11 a.m. on Sunday. Winds starting to pick up over 30 miles per hour, certainly up to 45 miles per hour in terms of gusts. That's going to be 5 p.m. on Sunday as the center is approaching. And then this is kind of where the center of the cone is, to bring it on shore somewhere in southern Miami-Dade or the Upper Keys. That's when we're gusting to 60. And now I'm kind of expecting wind gusts up to 65 miles per hour possible on the coastline, especially. That could cause some scattered power outages. The timing is mainly late Sunday into early Monday. That's on top of 6 to 10 inches of rain. We could get some locally higher amounts in excess of 10 inches. That's all the rain we see from today through the end of the day on Monday. We see some improvement coming as we get towards Tuesday, though. The rain breaks up a little bit. Hopefully we can catch a little bit of a break.